So Wix, is it a website builder you should use? It's definitely a website builder I am sure you have heard of, because Wix seems to advertise more than anyone else I know on the planet. You may have even seen an ad for Wix before this video. That's how much they advertise. But is Wix any good? Is it a website builder you should use? I'm going to answer that question in this video, and I'm going to tell you what I think of Wix and whether it's worth using. I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and it's my mission to help you find the best and easiest ways of building great-looking websites. If you're interested in getting Wix, definitely check out the link down below. That link helps to support this channel, and it helps to support all the reviews that I create and the free tutorials that I make. So I definitely thank you guys for your support. So let's go ahead and dive in and check out Wix and see what's up with this website building platform. So what I've been doing is testing out different website builders, trying to figure out what the best website builder is and what is the best website builder for different situations. So if you want to find out what my top recommended website builders are, definitely check out the link at the top of this video and down in the description below, where I've got my video that shows the best website building tools and the best website building platforms. One of the first things that I really do like about Wix is all of the templates that they have and how good they look. I mean, I think that if you're just looking for website inspiration in general, definitely looking at the templates that Wix offers is a great place to get some inspiration. So this here is the portfolio page that I created with Wix. Pretty good looking, pretty basic. I actually think if I wanted to, I could have gone a lot farther with the design on this using Wix. Wix offers some amazing design tools. The Wix editor is basically like a page design software. It's, you know, somewhat similar to like Adobe InDesign or Adobe Illustrator. It gives you a lot of control to place things exactly where you want them on your website. And I think that can be really good for desktop website design, like what we're seeing right here. And Wix also does create a mobile version of your website. But the great thing about Wix is that you have a lot of control over setting up and designing and making sure that the mobile version of your website looks just as good as the desktop version. And that's something I really like. It's something that other website builders don't offer. Either there's zero control over what the mobile version looks like, it's just auto-generated for you using responsive design, or there's not enough control over it. So as we go further into looking at this, you know, the portfolio options for a Wix website, I think, are, you know, really fantastic. There's a lot of different layouts for portfolio pages. These portfolio pages, the gallery images, are responsive, so they work well on both mobile and desktop. And Wix definitely offers some of the most options when it comes to gallery page designs. So if you're looking to build a portfolio website, I would definitely consider looking at Wix, just because there's so much you can do, and if you're a design-minded person, Wix gives you a lot of control over the design. And I love having all of these different layouts available on the gallery pages. I think that's really cool. And, you know, designing sort of any kind of pages, any kind of layouts that you want, Wix is definitely really good for that. And if you're one of those people that hates responsive design because, you know, your images move around on desktop depending on the size of the window and things like that, and you can't get things to pinpoint exactly where you want to, Wix does allow you to do that. And I think the fact that, you know, Wix gives you that control for desktop layout and then also very good control over the mobile layout, I think that that's, you know, a great feature and a great option for people who are really sticklers in design. So here's a second website that I created with Wix, just a very simple restaurant website. And one of the things I noticed about Wix is that they offer a lot of different tools for various different kinds of businesses. I think that that's one of the strengths of Wix, is all of the different apps that they offer that you can add to your website. Some of the apps that I found that, you know, might be useful for different businesses are, if you want to offer a subscription service, there's an app for that on Wix that allows you to get those reoccurring payments. You can sell prints or photos online, digital prints, have it sent out to do prints, mugs, canvases. So if you're a photographer and you're looking to sell your photographs, you can just add that right to your Wix website. I think that that's fantastic. If you're interested in building calculators to help people figure out things, there's a calculator builder on there. And there's all sorts of different tools for restaurants. There's a reservation tool, there's an online ordering tool, there's special menu functionality that you can add to your website. And you can even add an online store to Wix. And I haven't taken a deep dive into Wix for an online store, but I think that it's probably something you could use for, definitely for a limited number of products, maybe more. Right now, I like Shopify the best for creating an extensive online store, and you can check out my review of Shopify. I've actually used it to build an online store before. But I think that, you know, if you really want design control and if you don't have that many tools to sell, Wix could be a good option for selling online. So what is it like designing pages with Wix? Well, you get a lot of control, as I said before, to design your pages just the way you want them. Wix doesn't have exactly page sections. They call them strips, and they do work a little bit different than typical page sections that you might find on other website builders. Because one of the problems that I actually had was the strips, they're pretty easy to add. You just go over here to add strips, and then let's just add a basic strip like this testimonial one here. It's going to add it into the bottom of your site, and then you can, you know, sort of drag it like this, or you can resize it like this. And I think that's one of the things that I had sort of an issue with is when you drag it, it's actually making extra space behind your website, which you might want to do if you have like a really cool website background and you want to reveal that as people are moving through. But I found it was way too easy when adding a new strip to either overlap it or wind up having a small gap that you didn't intend to, and getting rid of that gap can be kind of frustrating. And I think that's kind of the thing with the Wix Builder is it has a lot of tools, a lot of design control, but because of that, it's also gonna take you a little bit longer to build your website. But you do get that sort of like fine-tuned control over everything on your website. One of the things that I do like about Wix is the global controls that you get over colors and text. One thing is that I didn't find that there was an easy place to just go and say like, okay, right now I just want to set up the global text and global colors for my website. Kind of have to dive into one of the elements to make those adjustments. But for example, if I click on this text here, I click edit text. If I change any of these attributes of the text, if I change, you know, the font type, if I make it bold or italicized or I change the color, I can click to save theme. And then every time this paragraph one text type comes up, or anytime I add this paragraph one text type, it's automatically going to default to those settings I had. But you still also have the ability to change, you know, the paragraph look for just this one section or even just one word. And I think that that's a great level of control. Some of the other website builders I've looked at, if you want to change the color of just one word to emphasize it, you're kind of out of luck. But with Wix, you've got full control over pretty much all of the design. And it's the same thing with the colors of your website. There is a color palette, sort of a default color palette. And I found that the easiest way to get there is to go to one of your strips, click on it, click change strip background, and then click color. And then here we've got the sort of default colors that I've already changed for this website. But if you click on change here, you've got different color palettes that they're suggesting for you. And then you can also manually change them by pushing these buttons down here. I just think that getting those types of things set up, getting your fonts set up and the colors that you want them to be, getting the general colors for your website set up, can definitely save you a lot of time in design. One of the other things that I think makes Wix a little bit slower for designing your website is that, you know, it'd be nice if I wanted to add another text block down below this, if there was just a little plus icon and I could automatically grab that. But every time you want to add a new piece of content to your page, you need to use this plus add button, and then you've got all of these different options of the type of content that you can add. So you can add text, you can add images, gallery, etc. But to do it, you need to select text, select the kind of text you want, and then drag it over your website, position it where you want it to be, etc. So it's a little bit time consuming. But I think that that's kind of part of the trade-off of having all of this control that you have. One of the other things that I do like about Wix is that when you do add a strip to your site, you've got all these different pre-made designs to sort of help you get started. Just like that, you can add it and then you can modify it to fit your needs. And I think that having those pre-made sections like that can really help you speed up your design of your website. One of the things that I also like about Wix is that if you're building a website that has a lot of content on it, a lot of images, you get a lot of control over the media that you've added to your website. So if, for example, I go over here and I click on image, my uploads, there are all sorts of different ways that I can manage the media that I've uploaded. I can add folders, I can create boards, I can remove things. There's also the option to add images from Shutterstock or media from Wix or Unsplash, which is a free resource for royalty-free images that you can add to your website. There's definitely a lot of choices there. And I also like the fact that, you know, when you're building a Wix website, you've got vector art that you can add to your website that's included, logos and badges that you can add, sort of all sorts of things that just make it really easy for you to add interesting elements to your website. I also got a chance to check out the tech support offered by Wix. And I was actually pretty impressed by it. I don't know whether it was the time of day or what, but when you dive in and you figure out how to actually contact a Wix tech support person, they actually just give you a phone call and then you talk about it over the phone. And when I contacted tech support, the support agent was able to help me out. They were able to, over the phone, walk me through exactly what I needed to do to resolve my issue. And not only did it resolve my issue, but it also showed me in the future how I can handle it myself. I think that for easy to use website builders, having great customer service like that, that you can get a hold of and you can actually talk to a person either via chat or on the phone, is definitely really helpful to helping you get your website up and running quickly as possible. Wix also does offer some pretty good blogging functionality for an easy to use website builder like this. So far, I haven't found anything as good as WordPress for doing a blog. So if blogging is a really important part of the website you want to make, I really think that WordPress seems to be where you need to go. But if blogging is something that's important to your website, but not something that's, you know, the thing that your website is all about, I think actually Wix offers some pretty good options. They're actual category pages, so when you create a new category, it actually creates a new page that you can link to. There's several different layout options for how your blog feed is gonna display, and then you do have some control over how your blog pages are gonna display and how your single blog posts are gonna display. And I think that's a really good feature. I also like the blog post editor. It's fairly easy to use. It's easy to add text. It's easy to add images. There's not a lot of control you can have. You can't go crazy with the design on your blog pages. But I think that's, you know, not necessarily a bad thing. You should keep the design of your blog post simple. So I definitely think that if blogging is an important part of your business, Wix is not bad for that. It's actually an okay blogging platform, just as long as blogging isn't your main function for your website. So what are my final thoughts on Wix? Is it a website builder that you should use? Well, I definitely think, first of all, you should check out my top recommended website builders and see if one of those is better for your needs. But I do think that if you're the kind of person who really likes a lot of control over the design and layout of your website, Wix is a good option. It has a ton of control over the design and look of your pages, particularly for desktop, but it also does a pretty good job of giving you control over the mobile look of your website. And that's really important to have that good mobile experience. If you're looking to build a website as quickly and easily as possible, I definitely think that there's some better options out there. You don't get anywhere near the design control, but you can get a website up and running really quick. For example, Jimdo is one of the website builders that I've tried recently. That makes it ridiculously fast and easy to build a website, but you don't really have that much design control. But I did really like the style and look that it creates for websites. And if you do like this sort of page design first style website builder, I'm gonna put a video out that's gonna talk about some of the different page design first website builders, kind of like Wix, that are alternative to Wix. I also think that Wix is a really good option for adding different functionality to your website. I mean, WordPress is probably the best for adding functionality, but with WordPress, you're a little bit on your own. It's really up to you to make sure everything works right. With Wix, they've got great customer support, and I'm sure that they'll be happy to help you out getting some of that added functionality working on your website should you have any problems. So that's something that I really think Wix is good for. But if you've had a chance to use Wix, tell me about it in the description below. Do you like it? Is it something that was too frustrating for you to use? Or just in general, what was your experience using Wix? And for more tutorials and website building reviews, definitely be sure to check out my website, realwebsitehints.com, and some of the other videos on my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.